Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to wire up your auxiliary switches in your Super Duty. So I had a client bring me their Super Duty and they have a welding truck as you can see, but they want to be able to see their job site more. This truck will go pretty much anywhere, so they need to be their own work site with their own lighting. So it makes sense to me. So they provide me some lights and today we're gonna wire them up. Now correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe Ford started doing auxiliary switches for outfitting in roughly 2008. The whole point of this install is to be super functional, but we still need it to be aesthetically pleasing and also be serviceable. So what we did here is we tapped the aluminum, use quarter 20 hardware with a washer, and then what we're gonna do to finalize it, because I don't know where this thing's gonna go, just a little bit of fluid film on top. Even though our hardware's plated, I want it to last as long as possible. So instead of zap strapping here or running P clamps or anything like that, we ran the wire inside the aluminum tube, came back out, but for our lights out here, we ran just outside and zap strapped everything out of the way, that way the reels can still work, but everything's really serviceable. Now, one thing the client asked was, they want this sled to be removable. So you can see it's inside the vehicle and secured to it, but the whole assembly can come out as one, pretty cool. However, if we don't put on connectors, our lights will get ripped out. So what I've done here is I've put Deutsch connectors on and I've just used 2-pin ones. So I like these because they are very good as far as protecting from the elements, and they're also easy to plug in and unplug. So to make sure that auxiliary 1 and 3 don't get mixed up, I've actually inverted the plug. So I have the male on one end and then I've reversed the plug orientation. That way you can never plug these in backwards. And then over here, we have it on the other side. So the nice thing about these Fords are there's plastic here. You just knock this out, drill a hole and drop the wires down. Very easy. So they do this for RVs and other accessories if you need to run wiring in them. So looking underneath, this is how we run our wire. So it comes here, meets up with the factory wiring. Then there's a crossover wire here underneath the spare. We go with that. And then we bring the driver's side wire over. Then they both join up. You'll see there it is there. And then we just keep on going. Run with all the factory stuff over here. And then it's a box frame. So on older trucks, they would usually run in the channel. Can't do that on these. So from factory, they ran out here. So we match it. So we come over the fuel tank, matching all the factory wiring. And under the hood, you can see we came up. I'm using the factory studs. And I'm putting M6 nuts and a washer on. And then I'm using a stainless steel clamp with insulation on it. And I've also added Testa tape on top of my loom as well, just to help with a little bit of heat and also any chafing. So we come up and over, and then we come over here. Ford's really thinking ahead, that they understand that people want to put things on their truck because they need to customize it depending on the application. So if we look over here, this is the passenger side, here's the battery, here's a fuse panel. And if you look, if you take apart the harness over here, you'll find all these pigtails. And a legend over here telling you what each relay number is correlating to the color. So if you guys are ever wondering what that nylon string or metal wire is when you're running conduit that's in a sheath, it's to help you split it apart. So as I pull it, then I can take off the sheath, exposing the insulated wire. So we're entering our final stages. I've elected to put our ground here. I usually try to pick factory grounds because it's been tested by the engineers. I've also mimicked the tapes. We're using a stereo Testa. I've twisted the wires. That way it mimics everything. And I'm also running through a clamp meter. These are such a low draw device, but I figure we'll just run it exactly how factory has it as well. So we have all our wires here. It's grounded. And we're going to verify our connections and each wire, because all my wires look the same. I don't know which one's which. So we'll just hook up the battery. So that's my passenger rear. Driver's rear. And finally, passenger side. So now all I have to do is hook it up to auxiliary 1, 2, and 3. As I'm hooking up my wires, I'm also testing and verifying the wires as I go along. Now popping off the cover for the relays and the fuses, we can see that it actually can do some substantial pull, 20 to 25 amps. And those things back there maybe need 5 amps at most when they first fire up, not even. So you have a lot of options to what you want to hook up to this. So understand what you're hooking up and know what its nominal value is when it's running. That way you don't stress out these components. And to do my final connections, I've elected to solder and shrink tube to keep everything nice and thin and give me a nice secure connection. When you're done, it should look something like this. Everything is secured to the factory wiring. I've tucked everything on the side. Because the factory wires are terminated, I've left it out and I've just zap strapped it here in case we ever need to go back and hit the other auxiliaries. It makes it easy to find, easy to access. Okay, so we're gonna test. We're gonna test auxiliary 1. Now we're gonna hit auxiliary 2. And now we're gonna do auxiliary 3. Let's see how it looks when you turn off some of the... That's pretty bright, check that out. So it seems to be more of a spotlight that he purchased. These two look like spots, the other one looks more like a flood. But this should do him good on the job site. And there you guys have it. That's how you wire up the auxiliary switches in a Super Duty.